afternoon, dear students. A very good morning to all of you. I hope you're all doing good. Now, in this session, I'm going to start the new chapter, that is thermodynamics. Thermodynamics is one of the important chapters of first PU chemistry. It comes under the physical chemistry branch. The weightage of this chapter is around 10 marks. That means, if you study well, you are going to get around 10 marks from this chapter alone. And definitely, you are going to get at least one problem from this chapter in your annual examination. Okay? Okay, now let's start the chapter with a fresh mindset. Thermodynamics means, in Greek, thermo means heat. Dynamics means motion or movement. So, the meaning of this term thermodynamics is heat which is in motion or heat which is in movement. Now, let us see the definition of thermodynamics. Thermodynamics is the branch of science which deals with the study of different forms of energies and the quantitative relationship between them. You know about different forms of energies, right? So, thermodynamics mainly concerned with the different forms of energies and the quantitative relationship between the different forms of energies. To understand this thermodynamics concepts, first you need to know about some of the basic terminologies. They are, first one, system. Second one is surrounding. Third term is boundary. You definitely have come across these terms in your day-to-day life. But the meaning of these terms in this chapter will be completely different. If you use these terms in your day-to-day life, they may have different meanings. Okay? But in this chapter, the meaning of these terms will be different. Now, let us discuss about them one by one. What is system? In thermodynamics, system means any specific part of the universe or specific portion of the universe which is under thermodynamic consideration or thermodynamic study is called system. If I consider this chalk face for the thermodynamic study, then this chalk face will be our system. Or if I consider this duster for the thermodynamic study, then it will become our system. Okay? Any part of the universe which is under thermodynamic study is called system. And now, the surrounding. Except the system, remaining portion of the universe is called surrounding. Except the system, everything in this universe constitutes the surrounding. According to thermodynamics, system plus surrounding is equal to universe. Is equal to universe. That means, you know that system is nothing but a specific portion of the universe which is under thermodynamic study. Surrounding is nothing but except system, everything in this universe is surrounding. So, system and surrounding will constitute the universe. But practically, we don't consider the entire universe as the surrounding. Because it doesn't make any sense to consider the entire universe as the surrounding. For practical purpose, the region of space in the neighborhood of the system is considered as the surrounding. That means the region of space which has some interaction with the system is considered as surrounding. For example, if I take this duster as the system, then this room will be its surrounding. Okay, I hope you got this. Now, let's move on to the another term, that is boundary. Boundary is nothing but a layer which separates system from the surrounding. This boundary may be real or imaginary. If the boundary is visible, if the boundary is sensible, that means if we can sense the presence of boundary, that type of boundary is called real boundary. And if we cannot sense the presence of boundary, That type of boundary is called the imaginary boundary. And now let us discuss about some other types of boundaries. First one is adiabatic boundary. Adiabatic boundary. What is adiabatic boundary? The boundary which does not allow the heat to enter the system or to exit from the system is called adiabatic boundary. It does not allow heat. It does not allow heat to exchange between the system and surrounding. Okay. Now another type of boundary is diathermic boundary. Diathermic boundary. Diathermic boundary is exactly the opposite of adiabatic boundary. If the boundary allows the heat to enter the system or to exit from the system, that means if the boundary allows the heat to exchange between system and surrounding, that type of boundary is called diathermic boundary. So this is all about the types of boundary. Okay, now let's move on to the types of system. There are different types of system. The first one is open system. What is open system? The system which exchange energy as well as matter with the surroundings is called open system. The system which can exchange energy as well as matter with the surrounding is called open system. For example, hot water taken in a open steel glass. If I take the hot water in an open steel glass and keep it aside for some time, after some time the water will become cold. Why? Because the heat energy present in the water has exchanged with its surrounding through the open space and also through the walls of the glass. Since it is made up of steel, you know that steel is a good conductor, right? So through the walls of the glass and also through the open space, the heat energy will exchange with the surrounding. Hence the water will become cold. Also, since it is an open glass, some of the water molecules may evaporate into the surrounding. That means matter also exchanges with the surrounding. So what is open system? The system which exchange both energy as well as matter with the surrounding. Now let's move on to the second type of system, that is closed system. Closed system. What is closed system? The type of system which exchange only energy with the surrounding but not the matter. The type of system which exchange only energy with the system but not the matter with the surrounding. Okay, that type of system is called closed system. For example, hot water taken in a steel glass and which is closed with the lid or plate. If I take the hot water in a steel glass and closed with a plate and keep it aside for some time, after some time the water will become cold. Even if it is closed, the heat energy has exchanged with the surrounding through the walls of the glass. Since the walls of the glass is a conductor, it's a steel, hence the heat energy has exchanged with the surrounding. But since it is closed, water molecules cannot get evaporated into the surrounding, so that matter cannot exchange with the surrounding. Okay, so what is closed system? The type of system which exchange only energy with the surrounding but not the matter. Example, hot water taken in a steel glass which is closed with a lid or plate. Now let's move on to the third type of system, that is isolated system. Isolated system. The type of system which does not exchange energy as well as matter with the surroundings. The isolated system does not exchange energy as well as matter with the surrounding. okay, the type of system which does not exchange energy as well as matter with the surrounding is called isolated system. For example, thermoflask or hot box, etc. They are the examples for isolated system. If we keep the hot water in the thermoflask, even after several hours, the water in the thermoflask will be still hot, right? Why? Because this thermoflask does not exchange the heat energy with the surrounding, since it's a isolated system. But these examples are not the perfect examples for isolated system. Why? Because a thermoflask cannot keep the water hot forever. For several hours, it can keep the water hot, but it cannot keep the water hot forever, right? For some time, it acts as isolated system, not forever. So, the perfect example for isolated system is universe, the universe itself. Universe itself is the perfect example for isolated system. You know that universe is the ultimate thing, right? So, there is nothing beyond this universe. The energy and mass present in this universe is constant. It doesn't going to exchange with anything else. So, universe is the perfect example for isolated system. From the point of examination, these three types, that is open system, closed system and isolated system, are very important. The definitions and examples are very much important. Okay. Now, let us discuss other types of system. The other type of system is homogeneous system. What is homogeneous system? The system which is completely uniform throughout and it has a single phase in it. That type of systems are called homogeneous system. Here this phase means either solid phase or liquid phase or gaseous phase. If the system is completely uniform throughout and has a single phase in it, then that type of system is called homogeneous system. Example for this homogeneous system is any pure solid or any pure liquid or any pure gas or the mixture of gases. These are all some of the examples for the homogeneous system. Now, let's move on to the another type of system, that is heterogeneous system. Heterogeneous system. The system which is not uniform throughout and has more than one phase in it, then that type of system is called heterogeneous system. The example for this heterogeneous system is the mixture of immiscible liquids such as oil plus water. Is the example for heterogeneous system, and even the sand plus water also the example for this heterogeneous system. Now let's move on to the another type of system, that is last type of system, that is macroscopic system. As the name itself indicating, it has macroscopic nature. That means if the system has large number of particles in it, then that type of system is called macroscopic system. Remember one thing, thermodynamics always deals at macroscopic level. It does not concern about the microscopic things. It always deals at macroscopic level. Okay. So this is all about the types of system. In this type of system, the first three types, that is open system, closed system and isolated systems, are very much important from the point of examination. Okay. Now, let's quickly recall what and all we have discussed in this session. We have discussed about the meaning of thermodynamics, the definition of thermodynamics, and then we have discussed about some of the basic terminologies such as system, surroundings and boundary. In that, we have discussed about different types of system and also different types of boundaries, right? Okay, in the coming session, I'm going to discuss about the properties of system. Thank you.